Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier this morning or yesterday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX successfully launched their 67th mission of the year with Starlink 618.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The boost which launched this mission, B1060, then landed successfully for the 17th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
We can also hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch tomorrow. The Starlink 73 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 25th at 7:23 a.m. UTC or 3:23 a.m. EDT. This coming week, we can also hopefully expect yet another Starlink launch as well. The Starlink 619 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 28th at 10:53 p.m. UTC or 6:53 p.m. EDT. I wanted to share some information posted by SpaceX's Jessie Anderson related to the Starlink 618 launch. She said, another upcoming milestone. Not only will our next Starlink launch be another 17th flight booster, but it will also be the 200th reflight mission. Our first reflight mission was SES-10 on March 30th, 2017. 6.5 years later, we are almost at 200. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a look at the launch site. Here you can see the work progressing very rapidly on the Star Factory expansion. I wanted to share this cool picture from a regular Starbase photographer of the white HLS nose cone that's been spotted recently. It would be awesome to see what's going on inside this nose cone. Related to Starship approval, there were a couple of bits of information posted. The first says US Fish and Wildlife officials have yet to begin a formal review of SpaceX's upgrades following Starship's first launch in April. This could push back the next launch window by months, which I know none of us want to hear. The next one says the agency still needs to review SpaceX's plans to operate a water deluge system during the next launch of its Starship rocket. This process could take anywhere from 30 to 135 days, the FWS said in an email to Bloomberg News on Monday. Musk responded and said that is unacceptable. It is absurd that SpaceX can build a giant rocket faster than they can shuffle paperwork. In relation to what Musk posted, I wanted to share some contextual information from the Ring Watchers. They said, for context, Ship 25 started construction at least before February 14th, 2022, fully stacked October 9th, 237 days. Booster 9 started at least before February 10th, 2022, fully stacked October 28th. 260 days. Recently at Massey's test site, SpaceX tested the 26.1 test tank to failure. After the test to failure of S26.1, I wanted to share this cool aerial shot of the remnants of the prototype. The Ship 26 prototype was unhooked from the crane, presumably for testing. The Ship 29 prototype was seen lifted onto the thrust simulator in the high bay. Ship 29 was also rolled out of the high bay and over to Massey's test site. The hot staging ring was seen being removed from the top of Booster 9. After recent cryogenic proof testing, the Booster 10 prototype was rolled back from Massey's. It was also moved back into the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.